In this video, we continue on a series of videos looking at steel conduit. If you haven't checked any of those out, I'll leave a link to the playlist in the description below. Jake said off camera, I've got a top tip for you, Gary. I love a top tip. He said, but I won't reveal my top tip until you hit record on the camera. Well, we're recording. What's your top tip?
So, Gary, when doing a 30-degree bend for a set, let's say, or a 90-degree bend, instead of stepping back and eyeing it up, I've got an inclinometer.
Inclinometer. That sounds something rather technical. When there's big words like that, we get Joe Robinson to do the videos. What's an inclinometer?
It's just a digital angle gauge.
Oh, right. So it'll tell us when we're at 30 and tell us when we're at 90.
Yep.
I haven't got one of those, but you've got one. So you're going to use it, and I'm going to show you a top tip to use one when he's gone. That's even magnetic. So you're going to set your horizon to zero, is that right?
Yep, so that's zeroed now.
Okay, so when you've pulled that down to 30, of exactly 30, we showed in a previous video where we did double sets that we'd like that first bend to be 30 degrees. So this will almost be able to be bang on, won't it? We'll flex a little bit, won't we, up there? You've got a tiny bit more
if you want it.
Yeah, if you want it. Ooh, he's going again.
Okay, yeah, so can't live with that, guys.
There's your top tip with a inclinometer. Have I said it right?
That's right, yeah.
Here's some correction fluid. Okay, and I'm going to show you a top tip using this. So we can see the roller bar or the arm of the conduit bending machine. We've obviously discussed that in a previous video where we talked about all the parts of a conduit bending machine. Well, we've actually got now a marked point here. If I could have a line here I could see when I step back, I'd actually know that that's approximately 30 degrees without the fancy bit of kit that Jake's got. So all I'm going to do is take my correction fluid and try and give myself a very thin line to follow when I step back. So as I sit this on here, I'm just going to brush a little bit of a line in just there. So I'll probably tidy that up at some point. So what happens now is when I pull mine down like so, and I can see my arm and that white line match, that will be approximately 30 degrees. So if you send this on to 90 degrees for me, I could paint myself another line and I won't need your fancy kit. Yeah, 60, 90, 110, you're about 75, keep going, 80, keep going. Almost there, it will spring back. So what are we at? Almost there.
Touch mark, yeah. A bit closer, I think.
Oh no, you're still miles out, a whole 2 degrees. Yeah, wow, yeah, I think we'll go with that. Just need to paint my second line in. Like so, there we go. So that means again, when I pull my arm down to that position there and I'm looking from here, I can see those two are matching. So the arm itself, and I'll wipe this off, the arm itself and the white line will give me 90 degrees. And in that position there, it'll give me 30. So 90, 30, or approximately. We'll let you decide in the comments who had the top tip there to setting it to 30 and to 90, but I think the correction fluid for me won.
Yeah, Gary, well, I thought I was really good coming in with my little gadget, and you beat me with the correction fluid, but I've got a question for you.
Okay, what's the question?
So what if your lines rub off?
Yeah, okay. What if the battery runs out in your device? What if you run it over with a forklift? What if you drop it in a bucket of water? What if you leave it at home? We can all play that game, can't we? I know the marks on this former are not etched there forever, and obviously they're only put on with Tipp-Ex, but it certainly gives you, as a student training, that way that you can set your conduit bending machine so you can get a 90 or a 30 in this case as well to near perfect every time without spending all that money on your inclinometer. As always, we're interested in your comments because he loves just answering them all. He has been for the whole of this series, so leave as many comments as you can below because Jake will get him back to all of them.